time to take a walk. Rosie admired Robin a lot because the latter carried much of God's anointing and grace. She seriously desired to have Robin as her spiritual mentor. She believed that with someone like Robin as her mentor, her spiritual growth would be very fast and she would be encouraged to fulfill her portion of God's work. Rosie eventually got what she wanted. Robin became her mentor. Rosie was excited and determined to learn as much as possible from her association with Robin. Soon, however, Rosie realized that she was not Robin's only mentee. She was just one of many, and she wasn't happy about that at all. She wasn't willing to share Robin with anyone else, and she told Robin so. She told Robin that her ministry, that is Robin's ministry, started and ended with her, that is with Rosie, and so she must stop mentoring other people. Every time Rosie saw a church member taking Robin's phone number, she became furious. She would then call Robin and unleash the anger and bitterness in her heart against the innocent woman, telling her that she was not supposed to share her number with anyone other than herself. Rosie always addressed Robin in a very disrespectful way because she was not happy that in spite of all her protests, Robin still continued to relate with and mentor others in their church and beyond. Robin just continued to take the insults that Rosie was throwing at her. After all, 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 12 says that anyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. As far as she was concerned, enduring insults from Rosie was part of the price she had to pay in fulfilling her own role towards raising people who would fight in the Lord's army. All she needed to do was continue to pray for Rosie, sharing the scriptures with her, showing her the love of God, and encouraging her to seek and serve God more. She would also continue to encourage Rosie to put God's word into practice. Someday, Rosie would change if she didn't give up on her and walk away because of her insolence. But things didn't change. Rosie became more and more insolent. She threw insults at Robin without seeming to care that Robin was an adult. Robin got to a point where she found herself wasting precious time trying to figure out how best to relate to Rosie without the latter finding one reason or the other to pour insults on her. And of course, as a child of God, working under the instruction of the Holy Spirit, she couldn't return insults to Rosie. She just had to accept whatever she handed to her and even apologize, although she knew she wasn't doing anything to deserve the outburst of anger and insults she received from Rosie. Robin was ready to put up with it all, praying and hoping that one day Rosie would realize her errors and change. But that was until the Holy Spirit spoke to her very clearly. Rosie has become a source of distraction for you. You are already spending too much time trying to find out how you can please her and stop the flow of insults. If you are not careful, she will succeed in making you lose focus and getting you completely out of the path that God charted for you. You need to distance yourself from her. That's paraphrased. That was it for Robin. She made a clean break from Rosie and received total restoration of her peace and joy. In a world where there is much self-centeredness, even among Christians, it is encouraging to know that there are still people like Robin who would patiently go to any length to help an ungrateful, insolent sibling in Christ. Matthew 22, verses 37 to 39. Jesus replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. A second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself." That's the New Living Translation. God wants us to love others as we love ourselves, and that includes forgiving and bearing with others. However, we understand from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, that there's a time to embrace and a time to turn away, a time to search and a time to quit searching, and also a time to keep and a time to throw away. No matter how much you love a person and desire to be a blessing to him or her, there may come a time when, for your own good, you need to step back and just love that person from afar. This is especially so when you try to help someone stand, but it's obvious that all he or she wants to do is pull you down. Whenever we find ourselves in that kind of situation, we have to be extra sensitive to the Holy Spirit so that we can hear when he tells us that it's time to walk away or shows us a different way to handle matters. You cannot love anyone more than you love yourself, especially when it comes to your spiritual well-being and ability to stay focused on God and the race he has set before you. And surely, you cannot love anyone more than Jesus loves them. Although he would like everyone to be saved, When he was sending his disciples out, he said to them in Luke chapter 10, verses 8 to 10, "If you enter a town and it welcomes you, eat whatever is set before you. Heal the sick and tell them, 'The kingdom of God is near you now.' But if a town refuses to welcome you, go out into its streets and say, 'We wipe even the dust of your town from our feet to show that we have abandoned you to your faith. And know this, the kingdom of God is near.'" If the Holy Spirit convinces you to walk away from a person, however, you must guard against developing hatred towards him. Do not stop praying for him. Do not make him a subject of gossip. He is not your enemy. You are only trying to protect yourself. Love that individual still, and if the Holy Spirit ever prompts you to reopen the closed door, do not hesitate. He knows all things. Jesus promised us peace. If there's any good thing you are doing right now that is robbing you of that peace and getting you distracted from what you should be focusing on, talk to the Holy Spirit about it. It's possible that it is time for you to walk away. May the Lord help us all in Jesus' name. Amen.